Most people don't like shooting at high noon, but guess what? It's high noon. Hello everyone, I'm Melissa New and welcome to this week's episode of Framed. So this artist uses something called a studio in the woods, and seriously guys, prepare to be inspired. We're so pumped to have you on the show.
I'm so happy to be here.
I'm so pumped. What is this? Where are we?
Well, this is my studio in the woods. Actually, today it's a studio in the desert.
Studio in the desert.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I love to work in the studio.
Yeah.
But I don't like to be in the studio. So, and I love to be outside in nature and hear birds singing and have the feel of the wind on your skin and have the actual breeze instead of a wind machine, you know, blow the models
hair. You like
hair.
The real thing.
I like the real deal.
Yeah.
And I don't know, it feels beautiful to be out here. I try to use a lot of symbols in my work.
Yeah.
They function two ways, one aesthetically and two symbolically. And I really like my light to come from above.
Yeah.
I believe in a higher power. And that's exactly what we're getting here is at high noon. The light comes directly from the top of this tent, down filtered. Basically, we have a 10-foot by 10-foot softbox.
Yeah.
And it's the most beautiful quality of light. So soft,
it
velvety.
Is so cool.
I don't have to move anything. I don't have to add a reflector. I don't have to add a kicker or any of that stuff. I can just organically work and connect to the human being who's in front of me.
Who is Jennifer? I mean, when photography and art is out of your brain, what are you doing? Who are you?
Well, that's a good question. Like, I teach a lot. I teach a lot of workshops and things like that, which I love to do. I love to share, you know, what I know
mm-hmm.
with other people and see other people light up.
Yeah.
And I love fashion.
Yeah.
I write.
You write?
I do. I write poetry. I write in my journal all the time.
Yeah.
I've been writing in my journal since I was 6 years old.
Really?
It's pretty cool. Yeah. I draw. I paint. I do encaustics.
What is encaustics?
Wax. Working with wax.
Whoa!
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
You are a true artist. When we first got here, when we rolled up in our RV, you came off the RV and you just took off into the desert. Why do you do that?
Well, I feel like I need to center myself.
Yeah.
And I love to walk and nature. Now that I live in Albuquerque, I do that a lot. I'll go drive out somewhere and just walk. When I lived in New England, I'd go out and find Louise May Alcott was one of my favorite authors, and I'd go kind of try to connect to her somehow and walk through Sleepy Hollow. And I don't know, it's a way of just calming down and recentering, and it's not anything ritualistic, it's just a peace of mind.
So what is this? Is this a part of your shoot today? Because I was holding it for something special, right?
It's just, I like the form of it. I usually find something that I think women in nature are really closely related. And I think, and then there's so many references to that in art. It's not a new idea. But I like the idea, and I think they're beautiful together. So I usually try to find something that has some kind of pretty form, and these are all entangled together, and use it as a prop.
But what's interesting is that as we were going through some of your work, you actually sculpt and build some of the things that you utilize in your studio or on location, right?
Right. That's one of the most important parts of, I guess, my art making.
Yeah.
It's almost like an offering or something like that.
Yeah.
That I like to make something, you know, some sort of labor. And as part of my work, it's really important, like, to make something with my hands, I guess. And then in my limited edition work, I make sculpture. And that's usually the base of the photograph.
Yeah.
And then I use human form and stuff in the final photograph.
You chose, out of everything that you do right now, what's taking up your time is photography. Mm-hmm. Out of all of these art forms, why photography?
Well, I think there's something, even though, you know, we're not in an era now where we see a photograph and think it's truth, mm-hmm. because we know that there's a lot of manipulation. I still think there's that element of truth, mm-hmm. in a photograph, that there's something when your heart sees it, you still believe a little bit of it.
Yeah.
Where, you know, you might see a painting or a sculpture, mm-hmm. And not feel the same way. Mm-hmm. And even, you know, and I manipulate my photographs quite a bit,
sure.
but there's still a human form, and I use, you know, human beings in all my images. I love portraits. There's still that true form, that true human spirit in there, mm-hmm. that hasn't been manipulated.
Right.
And I love that idea that yeah. that person has been captured in a true manner, mm-hmm. and not painted or sculpted. It's just a real image,
yeah.
that, I don't know, I think that's magic somehow.
And what's interesting about your work is that when we first saw and fell in love with your work, we were like, okay, is it digital? Is it tintype? Is it film? Is it old school Gregorio type, this type, that type? We didn't know what it was. And so tell us your process. Like, what is it that you go through, you know, your post side?
It's all of the above, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
A lot of my work is completely digital. So it starts with a digital capture, and then I scan tintypes, old tintypes, some that have been collected from flea markets and things like that.
Yeah.
Some I actually have just made plates of just nothing, so I could photograph just this background,
yeah.
and make a blank plate and scan that. So I just have a beautiful edge.
The texture.
Exactly.
Edge. Okay.
And make my border out of that, scan it, and make a texture that I can overlay in Photoshop.
Right.
And so that's a completely digital process.
Earlier when we were talking, you said, I'm constantly changing. Or
yeah.
when people see your work and you teach it, it's like, okay, now you need to challenge yourself to something different.
That's right.
Right?
Yeah, yeah, I don't know. I feel like as long as I'm not moving backward, and I'm not trying to be in front of anybody, mm-hmm. that's not, I'm not necessarily aware of where I fit in.
Yeah.
That's not important to me.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to make sure that I'm personally moving forward all the time, somehow.
Love
and
that.
Not moving backward, and I'm okay with that. Well, this is a little bit of Earth from Boston and from Texas and from Albuquerque, where I'm from.
Mm-hmm.
And I learned this from my Pueblo pottery class I'm taking right now. Where we, when we were digging clay from the earth, we blessed the earth again by throwing cornmeal into the wound that we had dug from to thank her for giving us the clay.
Wow.
And to almost state our intentions and to sort of give our spirit back. And I just loved that.
So what do you do?
So I just blow a little of my spirit.
Yeah.
And I just throw it
onto the set. Am I in the way?
No, you're fine.
Okay.
And no one has to see it or anything. I just do it to just kind of remind myself, you know, why I'm doing this.
Cool.
It's kind of fun. So that's all.
I love it. So do you want to just kind of describe your lighting situation? We had to rotate this a little bit.
Because of time of day.
Mm-hmm.
If we were here, when the sun was directly overhead, we wouldn't have to. This is pretty much the only background I use. I've got this one and one more.
Uh-huh.
This is a Kelly, I think it's called Kelly Beige. David Mayhew paints these for me.
he actually paints them.
Yeah, they're hand painted. He has one called Kelly Brown too, and they're my favorite. And I think they look really pretty when they're backlit.
Cool. Very cool.
And then otherwise, we've just got beautiful light coming in pretty much directly from above. Mm-hmm. And that gives me that gorgeous, almost like a butterfly pattern, if you want to call it that, in kind of a fashion. But it's so soft that you're not going to be able to say that's a defined pattern.
That's a butterfly light. Yeah.
It's just beautiful, kind of global light. And I can just work in there and not think about it. I can be connected to her, and that's way more important to me.
Right. So Penelope has what lens on her?
She has a 24-70. Mm-hmm. That's the only lens I own.
Wow.
That's really? My entire collection of gear.
That is your go-to.
That's it.
Wow.
That's what I have.
Let's do this.
All right.
I want to see you work your magic.
Okay.
You've blessed it.
I have.
Everything's there. Okay.
We're ready to go.
Work it.
One thing that's beautiful about this too is, especially if you have a model with pale eyes like she's got, on a day like this, the blue sky and open sky that she's looking at will just light up her eyes. It's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
So another thing that we talked about that I think is fascinating is you have two different things here. I mean, today we're doing portrait work. You're doing a portrait of a beautiful girl.
Right.
But you also go and you do, you know, these other things that actually have stories or meaning or your limited editions.
Right.
How do you go through the process of thinking, okay, today I'm going to get an old school machine and connect it to a man? I mean, right. How do you come up with these ideas?
Yeah, it's a really good question. And people ask me that all the time.
Yeah.
And it's I can tell you the answer in a couple parts, and it sounds simple when I can put it together in two sentences, but it's the hardest thing on earth for an artist, I think. Hmm. My work is all autobiographical, and so it comes from some kind of a personal place, and then as that word translate again. So, like, the series Medic came from a personal medical experience I was going through at the time. And it was terrifying at the time. Everything's worked out fine now. But then it was a lot of testing and a lot of wires and just, you know, frightening things. And, you know, I was in a wonderful relationship and we were in love. And so it was like that care that we had for one another, him caring for me and me caring for him, I wanted to translate how that felt in that time of trial. How do I put that on paper?
Yeah.
That's a gift. And it's also terrifying, I guess, when you're trying to figure out what would that look like if I wanted to make art out of that. First, you have to seize it and say, that's what I want to make art about. And then you have to figure out what it would look like.
Mm-hmm.
So I figured out that I wanted to make miracle machines about how people could care for one another if we could step into another realm and do that. So each machine is a miracle machine of how people could care for one another if they could step one step further, like record a thought and send it to someone while they were sleeping or, you know, things like that.
And so those machines you got were from old World War II.
Yeah, they were all atomic surplus and military surplus. Hundreds and hundreds of really strange gadgets. Once I figured out that's what I wanted to do, you kind of have to commit to it and believe in it. And never look back. Totally center in the background. Just be together like you have is great. We're gonna start with just some really easy, peaceful things, and then we might try to do some more involved yoga type looking things. So just knees together is fine. Totally centered, symmetrical. Hands by your side is good to start. Just kind of let your head fall to the side. Beautiful. It's beautiful just like that. Try bringing your hands back just a little bit. Still feet together is great. And let your head fall even more. Good. Roll your nose toward the sky. Amazing. Turn your body all the way center. There you go. You had it. You had it. You're perfect. Totally toward me. Beautiful. Feet all the way together again. Good. Try bringing, just letting your right knee fall forward a little bit and letting your hips just gently fall to the side. Weight on your right foot just a little bit more. Good. Mm-hmm. Either foot, really. You can just go either way. Yeah. Letting the hip just fall over. Yeah. Beautiful.
I think I want to go into your teaching a little bit, because what's unique about you is that you live and breathe art, but you also teach it, whether it's workshops, but you want to teach at a completely different level.
Yeah.
What are your goals with that?
Well, I think there's so many amazing people teaching technique.
Yeah.
And I believe that technique is extremely important. I'm not ever going to try to minimize that.
Yeah.
My hope for people is that they'll reach a level of technical expertise, mm-hmm. and get as good as they possibly can technically, and then mm-hmm. they'll come to somebody like me, or, you know, it could be me, it could be 1,000 other people, mm-hmm. Or that they'll find this on their own and operate at a higher level than that. Because mm-hmm. technique is this much of this.
Right.
You know, there's so much more than that.
Yeah.
When you're making, you know, a photograph that needs to mean more than a map of someone's face and right. what they look like. Yeah. Who cares? You know, anybody can do that. I think that's the state of our industry. Yes. I mean, you can do that with your iPhone.
Yeah.
And it will look pretty cool. Mm-hmm. You know, you can show me what I look like and I'll be happy with that.
Yeah.
There has to be more than that, you know? And that's how it operate at a higher frequency, you know, make it mean more than that.
And that's what you want to convey in your teaching.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's not going to be the same message for everybody, but, you know, everybody's going to arrive at that conclusion in a different way, mm-hmm. but maybe somehow, you know.
But you're not just studying it and getting a degree, you're getting an MFA.
Yeah.
And what does that mean?
It's a Master of Fine Arts degree. I don't actually know what it means. None of us do.
Something really cool.
Yeah. Well, we get to put the letters after our name and feel cool when we get out of school.
Right.
But it's kind of it's almost like a doctorate in art, uh-huh. I guess. And when I get out of school, I'd like to teach at the college level somewhere. I'd love to teach the rest of my life. I love teaching. So maybe if you're reaching kind of over your feet, kind of like a broken doll, mm-hmm. and your face is going to go up toward the light, toward the top of the tent,
yeah,
and just let your head fall over that way. So your whole energy is towards your feet, beautiful. And your hands can go up, yeah, that's amazing. If you can reach even further over,
yes, good. Oh.
If your head can almost go over your feet, we'll have it made, yes, yes.
You have officially inspired me to go shoot.
Good.
That was amazing. Thank you. these cameras, the viewers, are your classroom right now. What advice do you have for them? People that appreciate your work, know you, or are getting to know you, what do you have for them?
That's a good question. I don't know. I spend a lot of time. The best thing I can say is that, you know, when you watch videos of people doing things like this, it's easy to put us on a platform somehow.
Sure.
And it gives, you know, I just gave a master class yesterday and people came up to me and said things like, you know, I've been waiting to meet you or stuff. It's not, I don't want that. Because I just wanted, I spent so much time lying face down on my studio floor thinking I'm never going to make anything good again. Mm. You know, it's okay to feel like that. We all do. You know, I just want to present myself as a human being. And I want everybody to know that there's so many days that you just don't want to get up and make art ever again. And then there are days that you feel as triumphant as an eagle. You know, and there's going to be everything in between, but you got to trust that gift. That I don't want to sound woo-woo because I truly believe that that there's a capacity in every person that has chosen this path to make great work. Mm-hmm. But you have to trust that and study and work for it. It's it's there.
Love it. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Boom. I needed that.
My name is Jennifer Hudson. I'm a fine art photographer, and I've just been framed.
Frame Season 3 was brought to you by Bay Photo Lab. Like the music? Special thanks to Triple Scoop Music. Frame Network giveaways are brought to you by B&H. Head to giveaways.framenetwork.com for your chance to win. Find out more about the equipment used in this episode on framenetwork.com.
On the next episode of Framed.
So is this like a natural process that you just rub mud all over yourself all the time?
Yeah.
Head to framenetwork.com and create your passport login to gain exclusive access to Framed and your favorite shows, only on Flix. Thank you.